Welcome to worship here at Trinity Lutheran in Pelican Rapids. My name is Lee. I'm going to be leading this service today for you, along with a worship group called Off the Hook. Let's prepare our hearts and minds now for worship in song. To confession and forgiveness. God, we hear your invitation to us.
Come to me, you who are weary and heavy burden, and I will give you rest.
We acknowledge our soul's need for rest and quiet nourishment.
We lay down our burdens.
We acknowledge our soul's need of connection with you.
We confess our tendency to overlook rest as a necessary part of soul and self-care. We confess our pride as thinking that our work is so important that we may not set it down. We confess our readiness to believe that what we do determines our worth. We confess our obsession with productivity, results, measurable progress. We confess our tendency to forget that it is in you that we live and move and have our being, and that your love is better than life.
We ask now for body, mind, spirit, and whole person nourishment.
For rest and resurrection, for new life, for healing and consolation of our souls.
We ask for help in managing our time and activities so that our
infillings keep up with our outpourings.
Where we have overspent ourselves,
refresh us.
Where we have misplaced our priorities,
rearrange us.
Where we have said yes when we should have said no,
remind us.
We thank you for meaningful work, for blessings and burdens.
We thank you for rest. May we become present to our great need for daily bread, the presence of Christ in our lives. Amen.
Hear the good news of peace and salvation. God forgives us all our sins, not through our own work, but through Jesus Christ, risen from the dead. Rejoice in this amazing gift of grace.
Amen.
Alleluia. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. I once was blind, but now I see.
I got a peaceful, easy feeling. I know you won't let me down, 'cause I'm already standing on solid ground. Solid ground.
Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have already come. 'Tis grace has brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me home.
I got a peaceful, easy feeling. I know you won't let me down, 'cause I'm already standing on solid ground.
Peaceful,
easy feeling. solid ground. I walk in silence when it comes, this feeling when the spirit leads me on. If the dog should bark and the night is rough, I take it as a sign to rise above. This city to the hill among the clouds, where I can see my Savior now. He's waiting with his palms to me outstretched. His mercy is a balm when I'm perplexed. I find Jesus in the darkest night.
I find Jesus
in the morning light.
I find Jesus
in the face of those whose hearts are singing with a heavenly hope. Sometimes when I feel all alone, I look around and all are gone. The friends that I relied upon are busy doing what they want. I look within and I am told it's Sunday morning in my soul, and there I find a holy hall where congregations heed the call. I find Jesus in the darkest night.
I find Jesus
in the morning bright.
I find Jesus
in the face of those whose hearts are singing with a heavenly host. And when I lay down my last time and feel a chill run up my spine and recognize my time has come, I'll look around. He'll lead me home. He'll reach his loving hand to me, and then we'll climb to victory, where we'll find kindred spirits there, hearts raised in song without a care. I find Jesus
in the darkest night.
I find Jesus in the morning bright.
I find Jesus
in the face of those whose hearts are singing with the heavenly host.
Our first reading today comes from the book of Genesis, chapter 45, verses 3 through 11, and verse 15. Joseph said to his brothers, "I am Joseph. Is my father still alive?" But his brothers could not answer him, so dismayed were they at his presence. Then Joseph said to his brothers, "Come closer to me." And they came closer. He said, "I am your brother Joseph, whom you sold into Egypt. And now, do not be distressed or angry with yourselves because you sold me here, for God sent me before you to preserve life. For the famine has been in the land here for 2 years, and there are 5 more years in which there will be neither plowing nor harvest. God sent me before you to preserve for you a remnant on earth and to keep alive for you many survivors. So it was not you who sent me here, but God. He has made me a father to Pharaoh and lord of all his house and ruler over all the land of Egypt. hurry and go up to my father and say to him, thus says your son Joseph, God has made me Lord of all Egypt. Come down to me. Do not delay. You shall settle in the land of Goshen, and you shall be near me. And you and your children and your children's children, as well as your flocks and your herds and all that you have, I will provide for you there, since there are 5 more years of famine to come. So that you and your household and all that you have will not come to poverty. And he kissed all his brothers, and he wept upon them. And after that, his brothers talked to him. Joseph offers up a new way of life and a new way of living for his brothers. Do you think he changed his brothers' hearts by not retaliating? His brothers were expecting him to retaliate. Maybe Joseph just captured his brothers.
I heard your echo in the canyon, up on the timberline. You said these mountains were your invention, and so was this heart of mine. I heard you whisper on the water, there on the mighty sea. You spoke of love deep as the ocean when you spoke of your love for me. I am loved by the Father. I am the heart of this wayward one. I heard your laughter in the sunrise amidst the morning birds, a song of freedom for all creation, and you sang me every word. I am loved by the Father. I am loved by the Son. It is love that has captured the heart of this wayward one. Singing in the silence, a simple melody, words of love, oh, I can hear them. My Father is very fond of me, and I am loved by the Father. It is love that has captured the heart of this grateful one. I am loved by the Father. I am loved by the Son. It is love that has captured heart of this grateful one.
Our gospel today comes from the book of Luke, chapter 6, verses 27 to 38. The Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, O God. And Jesus said, "But I say to you that listen, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you, pray for those who abuse you. If anyone strikes you on the cheek, offer the other also. And from anyone who takes away your coat, do not withhold even your shirt. Give to everyone who begs from you. And if anyone takes your goods, do not ask for them again. Do to others as you would have them do to you. If you love those who love you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners love those who love them. And if you do good to those who do good to you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners do the same. If you lend to those whom you hope to receive, what credit is that to you? Even sinners lend to sinners who receive as much again. But love your enemies, do good, and lend, expecting nothing in return. Your reward will be great, and you will be made children of the Most High, for He is kind to the ungrateful and the wicked. Be merciful just as your Father is merciful. Do not judge, and you will not be judged. Do not condemn, and you will not be condemned. Forgive, and you will be forgiven. Give, and it will be given to you. A good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will be put into your lap. For the measure that you give will be the measure that you get back." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Wow. This Gospel reading comes from what they call the Sermon on the Plains. I like to call it the Sermon on the Level. Jesus came down to the same level as everybody who was present there. The sick, the lowly, the priest, the hierarchy, all the way from the lepers, they were all on the same level at this service. Just before this reading part, remember last week, there was the blessed part and the woe part. And it went like this: blessed are the hungry and the poor and the weepers. And woe to the rich, the full, and those who laugh. This is a dangerous message. Jesus seems to be taking names here. He's offending some people. Danger, danger. The first line of the new reading says, "I say to you that listen." In last week's gospel reading, he'd already lost some people. He offended some people. They probably pulled away from Jesus and the way of the Lord. They didn't like what they heard. And now his response is in this next passage is, "I say to you that listen." First, he tells us to go love our enemies. And then do good to people that hate us. And bless those who are cursing us. And pray for our abusers. This is not easy to do. but it is in the image of our God. And then he gives us a description kind of how we can do this kind of stuff. I'm going to kind of summarize it here. You know, we're supposed to offer up the other side of our head after we get it hit once, and then turn the other way. Maybe we'll have matching black eyes. And just give away your shirt. You already stole my coat. Wow. Give my money all to beggars? And if they rob you, just let them have it. Oh, that came out wrong. If they rob you, just let them have it. This is a tough message, folks. Then he comes with this, simplifies this a little bit with this golden rule. Do to others as you would have them do unto you. When I was young, we wore wristbands. And they had an acronym on there, but what they stood for is, what would Jesus do? Does anyone wear any of them anymore? It was very popular in the late 70s and 80s. Maybe we should start hanging our wristbands on again. We should be really loving our enemies. We should be doing good. We should be lending. And we should expect absolutely nothing in return. We should be imitators of God. We should be merciful unto others as God is merciful unto us. We should not be judgmental. It sounds great, but can I do that? Right now, we live in a culture that is, so full of contempt and so full of grudges that I don't know that... There I go again. I'm looking for excuses to fit myself. He told me that my reward will be great. The measurement I give is the measurement I will receive. For those of you who are still listening, I'd like to share with you something that spontaneously showed up. When I was working on this message, I was struggling with where I was going to go with it, and sitting alongside of my easy chair in my little boys' club, where I spend a lot of time, is this daily devotional book that's been there forever. So I turned it to today's date of February 20th, and I would like to read this to you. For many people, life is a jungle. Not a jungle of trees and beasts. Our jungles are comprised of thicker thickets, of failing health, broken hearts, and empty wallets. We don't hear the screeching of the birds or the roaring of the lions, but what we do hear is the complaints of the neighbors and the demands of our bosses. Whether you are a lamb who is stuck out on a ledge or a city slicker stuck in a concrete jungle, everything changes when your rescuer appears. Your loneliness diminishes because you have fellowship. Your despair decreases because you have vision. Your confusion begins to lift because you have direction. You haven't left the jungle. The trees still eclipse the sky, and the thorns will still cut your skin. It hasn't changed, but you have. You have changed because you have hope. And you have hope because you have met someone who can lead you out.
I've been held by the Savior. I've felt fire from above. I've been down to the river. Ooh, I ain't the same. A prodigal returned. All my hope is in Jesus. Thank God my yesterday's gone. All my sins are forgiven. Ooh, I've been washed by the blood. I'm no stranger to this prison. I've worn shackles and chains. I've been freed and forgiven. I'm not going back. I'll never be the same. That's why I sing. All my hope is in Jesus. Thank God my yesterday's gone. All my sins are forgiven. I've been washed by the blood.
There's a kind of thing that breaks a man. It breaks him down to his knees. Lord, I've been broken more than a time or two. Yes, I have. And you pick me up and show me what it means to be a man and sing. I say,
all my hope is in Jesus. Thank God my yesterday's gone. Ooh, all my sins are forgiven. Ooh, and I've been washed by the blood. All my hope is in Jesus. Thank God my yesterday's gone. All my sins are forgiven. Ooh, and I've been washed by the blood. Washed by the blood.
Please join me in the reciting of our Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again, and he ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We'll continue with our prayer of intercessions. The Spirit of the Lord is poured out upon us in abundance so that we are bold to pray for the church, the world, and all that God has made. You teach us to love our neighbors and enemies alike. Encourage your church to follow the leading of your love, especially when it is risky or difficult. Help us to show mercy just as we have received mercy. God of grace,
hear our prayers.
Look upon our world with mercy, that we delight in the abundance of peace. Protect all whose lives are marred by war and civil unrest. Release political prisoners and amplify the voices that challenge us to seek forgiveness and pursue nonviolence. God of grace,
hear our prayers.
Your people cry out for mercy. Console hearts that long for forgiveness. Mend broken relationships. Heal bodies that suffer chronic pain or illness. We lift before you this day Artis Johnson, Brody Setter, Luke Von Felt, Dave McDonald, Mimi Urig, Steve Anderson, Terry Sorum, Carol Kuvas, Jim King, Dave Huseby, and Anna May Fossen, and all others whom we lift from our hearts. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
You bind us together into one family. Teach us to forgive one another and to resolve conflicts with humility and patience. Bless families of all shapes and sizes and show love to those who are lonely or grieving. God of grace,
hear our prayers.
We praise you for the saints who have inherited the fullness of your kingdom as you have raised them to imperishable and eternal life. Sustain us in faith by the promise of resurrection. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Since we have such great hope in your promise, O God, we lift these and all of our prayers to you in confidence and faith. Through Jesus Christ our Savior, amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Please join me in praying the prayer that Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. As you leave this place today, I'd like to leave you with this blessing. May God's mercy and grace give you enough hope for you to continue to listen. Amen.
So wonderful is your unfailing love. Your cross has spoken mercy over me. No eye has seen, no ear has heard, no heart could fully know. How glorious, how beautiful you are. Beautiful one. My soul must sing. Powerful, so powerful, your glory fills the skies. Your mighty works displayed for all to see. beauty of your majesty awakes my heart to sing. How marvelous, how wonderful you are. Beautiful one I love, beautiful one I adore, beautiful one my soul must sing. Beautiful one I love, beautiful one I adore, beautiful one my soul must sing. You've opened my eyes to your wonders anew. You've captured my heart with this love. 'Cause nothing on earth is as beautiful as you. You've opened my eyes to your wonders anew. You've captured my heart with this love. 'Cause nothing on earth is as beautiful as you. Beautiful one I love, beautiful one I adore, beautiful one my soul must sing. Beautiful one I love, beautiful one I adore you, beautiful one my soul.